Sir Carter. Taking back that $5. Hello, everyone. Netflix Anime Club is about to start. I'm here with Gon.
And I'm here with Joey. Hey, Joey. How are you doing?
I'm all right. How are you? There's no board between us, so I can see you clear as day.
I know. Hello. How are you doing, Joey?
Good.
All the way over there.
All the way over there.
We are safely social distancing.
Also, can we talk?
Oh my God, please, can we not? Can we not? We were asked to draw something literally 5 minutes before starting.
They were like, can you draw each other? And I was like, sure. So I drew Steve Handjobs, the one and only, and apparently I'm in the Garfield universe. What's his name? What's Garfield's owner's name?
I don't know.
Steve or whatever his name is?
An abomination, like, which is what that is.
I'm like Steve if he was in Requiem for a Dream.
We are going to be two... carry on the theme of hot summers, we're going to be having some hot takes. Kind of. We're going to be having some hot debates to do with anime tropes.
I love hot debates on anime. I had an entire show about it on my channel. Netflix definitely didn't rip me off.
So what we're going to be doing is we are going to be, I guess, picking a anime genre from this box.
Okay.
And we don't know what the anime genres are going to be. And from the anime genre, we have to say what our favorite tropes from that genre is.
Right.
Pick us a good one.
Come on, Gacha Gods. All right,
what do we got?
All right. Summer anime. So in other words...
I already know what I'm putting
anime
for this
Anime that
one.
Is based in the summer.
I already know what I'm putting for this one.
I know what I'm gonna put too, so... Oops, shit. All
right. So after we show our answers, we're gonna have 2 minutes to debate who has the better answer.
All right,
Joey.
Ready? Three, yeah. two, one. Set in the middle of nowhere.
Cicadas.
No, you wrote Sir Carter's. Did I say that right?
How do you spell cicadas?
There's no R in cicada.
Is there not?
That's Sir Carter.
Okay, well, this is meant
cicadas
to spell...
Cicadas that were rightfully knighted by the queen.
Sir Carter.
Sir Cicadas. Stan, Sir Carter.
I knight you. Sir Carter.
Sir Carter. I mean, I feel... It's kind of the same. I wrote down Inaka, as in like, you know, it's like in the middle of the mountains, rice fields everywhere, usually fucking nothing to do there.
So, that's got nothing to do with summer. There's like summer anime that's set in the city. No, it's not always in the summer.
Name me one summer anime that's set.
Literally every high school anime has a summer episode.
Okay, it has a summer episode, but it's not a summer anime.
Like, well, what counts as a summer anime?
Like, I'm talking like...
You're just thinking about Anohana, aren't you?
Anohana, Nononbiori, literally every slice of life that's set in the... Dagashikashi, all in the summer.
I'm sorry, but if there's one thing that indicates summer anime, it's cicadas. Anything, like, summer episodes, summer, anything in Japan, it's cicadas. It's not even anime. They tell me about this one time when the first year I moved to Japan, I was just like, damn, these cicadas noises are like really accurate to anime. And I thought I had like an anime playing on in the background.
Yeah.
And I didn't actually realize that the window was just open. And I thought the TV was on.
Like, whoa, it's like an anime.
I thought every anime used the same stock footage or stock sound effects for every cicada. And then I just realized, no, every cicada just sounds like that.
They're literally just like, shit, we need cicada. OBA opens window, just sticks the mic out. It's like, all right, good, we got it. It's just
like,
use that.
It's like every cicada just downloaded Audio Jungle and it's just using that.
Okay.
So yeah, that's our 2 minutes up.
All right, we're gonna ask the Netflix staff, which one is the more tropiest summer anime trope?
Of course, cicadas, of course. Come on.
I feel points need to be deducted for the fact that he can't fucking spell cicadas. I can't believe this man.
Fighting anime? Yeah.
Not action anime. Fighting anime. All right, I swear to God, I better win this one.
Okay, I hope we... this one was very on brand for me. I'd be remiss if I put anything else but tournament arc. I mean, come on. It's me, guys. Come on. Of course I was going to put this.
But I would argue not every fighting anime has a tournament arc. Every good one does, but not every one of them does. You know what every good or bad fighting anime does have?
What?
The protagonist never fucking dies.
Excuse me, Dragon Ball Z, I'm pretty sure Goku dies about 5 different times within that show.
I'm sorry, but when the credits roll at the end of the last episode of Dragon Ball Z, is Goku dead?
Yeah, I mean, technically he's dead.
I rest my case.
Go, like, remember the arc where he had a halo because he literally went to hell?
Yeah,
he
and
literally
then he was like,
went to the afterlife.
And then he was like, you know what, Kami? I think they need me back at. Oh, ring, ring, hello? Oh, yes, your boy is coming back. And then he comes back.
Look, the point is he was dead, but like, death is just like a minor inconvenience in the Dragon Ball universe.
No, but every fighting anime, it's like, every time, right, there's like an insane fight happening,
yeah.
I'm just like, this is the point. This is the RIP moment. And then for some reason the protagonist is like, not if I can handle it.
I'm pretty sure like every shonen protagonist dies at least once, and it's just like, it's like,
yeah,
some...
but they never like die.
Well, what kind of anime is there where the protagonist dies? All I'm saying is that
Akamega Kill.
let's not get into that. Like, that's, you know what Akamega Kill doesn't have? A tournament arc. That's why it's a bad anime, because it does not have a tournament arc.
You're right.
Like, it could even be a mediocre anime, and like, I sleep on mediocre animes, but if it has a tournament arc, I'll always give it a chance.
The tournament arcs that you always remember are from the good anime.
Yeah.
Right? Every fighting anime that has any amount of fighting, the protagonist is like...
That's not even a trope, that's just an anime trope. Like, that's just
But especially in fighting anime, though. I mean, at this point, tournament arc is a fucking anime trope. Anime has a tournament arc.
No, not every anime, but definitely every fighting anime. Okay.
God damn it.
I guess we've run out of time.
All right. I swear, I'm not about to sneak $5 into the judge's pocket if you pick me, but...
I'm gonna call this rigged, because if you can... No one beats tournament arcs, I'm sorry. It's the best.
Look,
anime
I should
trope.
Get a handicap. I don't watch anime, all right?
Yeah! That was such a pity win.
I'll give you $5 later. All right, last one.
All right, last one.
This is the decider.
All right.
Oh, shit.
What?
Robot anime.
Robot anime?
As in mecha anime, right?
Do you mean mecha anime?
Or just any anime with robots in it.
God
right?
damn.
So like Animatrix counts. Ghost in the Shell?
I went for like the most vanilla answer I could think of.
Sure, go for it.
I just went for politics. I was just like, the first one I wrote was like, villain wears the mask. And I'm just like, that's just Gundam. That's just like, every villain is like a Shah ripoff,
well, no,
right?
That's not true. Like Ava as well, right? Technically.
I guess
it's
so.
It's like an eye mask, you know?
Well, that's an Ava remake, but
that's true.
Most ones, we got the politics going on.
No, that's
like,
true,
got the
that's true.
Mechas.
I don't think you thought about this one. The pilot is never trained to pilot beforehand.
No, I think most Gundam pilots are trained to pilot beforehand.
I don't know, man. I mean, it's always that, like, you know, human drama element of like, oh, they're losing their minds because they don't know how to train. It's like, you know what? Maybe I'm not a good pilot.
That's just Shinji.
No,
that's not
the original Gundam. No, that's not true. Literally every single one, they're like, I don't know how to pilot this thing, but I guess I'm the only one that can pilot it. You know, that's how it goes.
Because you got like, what about Suzaku and Code Geass? So like, a lot of Code Geass, you got Full Metal Panic.
Yeah.
Okay, but so Sosuke knew how to pilot.
Okay, but
stuff.
What about like, you know, Ava, like probably a lot of Gundam pilots, Erica Seven, literally every other mecha.
Literally every other mecha. He says, oh, you're a mecha fan?
You
know, name every mecha.
Yeah, name every mecha.
Three.
Yeah. You know, those are the three that important.
Look, all I'm saying is mecha's known for two things in this golden era. One is the super robots.
Okay.
And the other one is the political war mechas, like Gundam. You know, like Code Geass, like Full Metal Panic and... Stuff like that.
Wow. Yeah.
Like, hello. I kind of feel like, hello, fellow mecha fans.
I do enjoy the robots, as you do.
Walks in with like a skateboard. Hello, fellow mecha heads. How are you doing?
All right.
I've run out of points I could make.
Yeah, I've literally run. As you can tell, we're not exactly the biggest mecha fans. So.
Okay. So who's the winner for this one?
Yes! No!
I'm the winner!
I'm taking back that $5. Alright.
Alright, so I guess we're gonna have a punishment game now.
Mm-hmm.
And since Joey was so bad at forming an argument, he has to come up with an anime story and a setting where he is the main character.
Are you serious? I literally have to do creative writing.
Yeah.
I was not planning to do that today. Okay. There once was a boy.
Uh-huh.
Named Joey.
And, why are you telling it like a bedtime story?
And he was assigned to pilot a mecha.
Oh my god.
A big mecha, the size of like a galaxy. And, but luckily, he had watched enough mecha anime in his days where he was like, oh, this is piloted exactly like the ones in Gurren Lagann. You know that show?
Daddy Joe, this is my favorite story. Tell the part about the big mecha, Daddy.
The big mecha walks
what does
in.
It look like?
The big mecha, it looks like a titan, but like a metallic titan. Like Mecha Sonic, but except instead of Sonic, it's a titan.
As much as I want to hear the end of the story, I've actually got one that I think is even better than yours,
oh, yeah?
Joey. Even though I'm not part of the punishment game, but I'll say it anyway.
So, okay.
So there's like this main character.
Uh-huh.
He's called Gant, right?
Yeah.
And he's just a normal...
That's not a real name.
No, it's all right, Grant then.
Yeah,
if that's what you really
that's
want.
That's better.
He's just a normal guy going about his day. He likes anime.
Uh-huh.
Then one day, get this.
Uh-huh.
He gets hit by a truck. Okay. Gets hit by a truck.
Does he die?
No, he doesn't actually. Because the protagonist never dies. And get this. He gets sent to another world. And you think it could be any world at all, right?
They're yeah.
Like you get sent to another world, could get sent to a mecha world,
yeah.
Could get sent to like any kind of different world. You get sent to a fantasy world. But you've never heard of that one before. And there's like magic and elves. And he has he gets a special power that makes him really overpowered in this world.
Yeah.
And like girls just start falling for him.
Uh-huh.
Like, doesn't that sound amazing?
Dude.
$1 million idea.
Stop talking, Netflix, they're recording this. Someone could just fucking snatch up and be like, mine now.
And yeah, if you want to steal that idea, go ahead. That's just, I'm giving it for free. $1 million idea for
wow.
free.
Wow. God's just giving away money at this point. God damn.
But yeah, that's been today's Netflix Anime Club. hope you enjoyed yourself here, Joey.
I always enjoy myself here at Anime Club, God.
I'm excited for the next club activity.
Same. I hope I don't embarrass myself.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.